No blood.
It's a fairy tale film compared to the rest of the
fucking song.
And that's what Friday wants.
That's what Friday sounds.
That's what Friday wants to do. Because he wants to do that kind of thing, but throw in the gore.
Yeah. Well, only in the later movies it got a little bit. It got really messy. And,
yeah, of course. And then by like Rob Zombies, it was Warfest, the two ones that are supposed to be with the continuity, they stuck up a lot.
That's the bard.
Like in the 2018
version, if it makes you feel
well,
sure. I'm gonna make the gourmet.
Sure.
How many games are left tonight?
What
are you
doing with those cookies I made
with the M&M's?
No, they're
in the fridge.
They're in the fridge?
Yeah, they're in the container in the fridge.
Oh.
For the AWA World Heavyweight Championship, a defunct title, an antique, if you will, is being defended tonight. Where members of the 5th edition Horvath, the Hungarian Barbarian, meets Brandon Wolfe, the Wolfman.
Indeed.
Who is with Big Sexy Kevin Nash, the NWO World Title, a World Championship belt. We haven't seen Nash in a while, but he still has the belt. No one's been able to dethrone him. And that says a lot about somebody. But this is not about Nash. It's about the win-loss record of these two individuals, Brandon Wolfe and Horvath. They are pretty much tied right now, and they're trying to get that 37th victory. Will they reach 37? I know I'll reach 37 next year, but that's a whole different story.
But I digress.
This broadcast, fans, has been brought to you by Konami. I used to play Konami video games till the cows came home, and I still do. It's our proud sponsor for the 20th FPW SuperCard event. And this should be a very, very classical match between, I believe, not just two superstars, but two champions, two future Hall of Famers of this biz.
Both being dominant forces at one point in this industry.
Fucking A, man. And there's Sky Stanley holding the belt. The capacity crowd sold out here at THQ Arena. Brandon Wolfe, the challenger. Horvath, the champion.
Because I've made one. I have no fucking idea what to call it.
Well, maybe we should have it based off of his name. That's what I was curious about. I was like, how do I call it there? It uses the word decay.
Well,
it's okay. I was thinking, well, he used to call himself Vision. Decaying Vision? No, that sounds weird.
No.
Anyways, he too, like you saw with the other mech from my cousin that had the blood on it. This is actually a rough sketch of it. It's very rough. He has big arms and fists, just like he has big fists and he fights the same way as almost like yours, but it's slightly different. And he has blood on arms and fists only.
Oh my.
Because he beats the shit out of people with it. And he has rocket launchers on the back, of course. And that's generally it.
Nice.
He looks fucking cool with like just walking. He has no cape or anything. So he's walking. Actually, you see blow on his big fists. That's just cool. Mm-hmm. But I have no idea what to call him.
My go-to is to search up online for some kind of a name generator. It usually works. All right, fans. We hope that you are enjoying SuperCard 20, not 20 years, but 20 editions. We had started this back in 2008. We never thought that we would take it this far. This massive crowd. Every seat in this building is taken. And we're seeing two classic superstars. As you mentioned, Scott Towels, these guys were the headliners at one point. They still technically are, which is why they're fighting here tonight for the AWA World Heavyweight Championship.
They have each faced some of the fiercest competitors in the FPW on their own accord.
Oh, yeah.
Outside of even facing each other, each of them have faced severe trials and tribulations. Horvath was brutalized in the past, hence all the scarring now on his body. He wears his history.
Oh, definitely.
Benjamin Stack has made his marks. But now Benjamin Stack...
That's true, eh?
But Benjamin Stack has been taken care of by Horvath. Brandon Wolfe is no stranger. A dominant force ever since, like, from when he came into the FPW.
Mm-hmm.
A severely powerful talent that seemed to always win.
And that
started to seem quite imposing at one point. Now, admittedly, his streak has been ended at one point, but that doesn't change the fact that these two competitors are about some of the fiercest competitors in the sport right now.
Yeah. And as you had mentioned, Benjamin Stack, yes, he is the man responsible for the burns, for the cuts, the bruises. Hell, we even lost a very expensive ring that rendered us to go into our emergency trust fund to rebuild a newer, better, sturdier ring.
What the fuck is that? Enough.
For which one?
The bar.
Oh, I can't remember.
Oh, it's a...
You mean that thing right there on the screen? It's the bard, the bard's bar.
I get it. Oh no.
German suplex. Hey, look at that. That was brilliant.
Tarzan has fallen.
My God.
What?
We have this on film, y'all. Get out of here, Nash. Come on, man. Don't be...
Oh.
And by the way, this is a best 2 out of 3 falls match, so just keep in mind. Cross arm breaker, the referee is in position. These two managers are brawling on the outside. Look at this. What a hell of a view right now from this from ringside. It's just gonna get more chaotic, I think, and Nash is now stalking the bard here. Stops right there.
Oh!
That just woke him up. Come on!
Whoa! Nash only barely getting out of the way of a careening Brandon Wolfe, who tumbles to the outside as this chaos continues.
Oh, it's going to be crazy, man. There you go. Finally, some kind of connection.
Uh-oh.
Oh, my. The bard now. I mean, Horvath setting Brandon Wolfe. The big boot. Oh, my fuck.
I'd love to see an environmental effect where the pole actually bends a bit.
Could you imagine?
Oh no!
Oh, I thought he was going to go to the steel steps. It looks like Brandon caught himself in that moment to prevent further damage. After all, his skull is probably crushed. Oh, knee to the gut. God damn. And looks like we have like a tag team match going on around here.
Oh,
unbelievable. This is gonna be brutal, ladies and gentlemen, for the AWA World Heavyweight Championship.
Oh, a brain buster.
Wait a second.
More interference. Oh, from Nash.
Manager ejected. The Bard has been asked to leave, and so is Nash.
This has now become a very straightforward fight.
Yep. As we had expected, there's no one to interfere. Oh my goodness, this match continues. We're still in the first fall, Scott.
That's right.
We still have a ways to go, but I'm loving this. Oh my goodness.
I thought he was gonna do the tiger suplex.
Tiger suplex. No, I guess he didn't get much leverage on that one, but now he's gonna go over that cover, trying to get the first fall, not even close, not even a two count. Unbelievable. Not what we had imagined here, but I guess this is all about a championship title. This is all about a win record. And now look at Horvath positioning Brandon, well, doing squats.
It's just the screaming on his face. Oh. He's like yelling in his ear.
So he's not only giving him back pain, but he wants to give him an earache or a headache.
He's getting a headache as well from the blood rush.
Oh my god. Northern Lights release suplex, a crossed arm breaker, trying to break that hand along the way. You can see the way the head is positioned.
Horvath is maintaining a very interesting balance between power and technicality and technical movements.
Snap dragon suplex. No. Oh, there it is. The very European uppercuts. One, two, no.
Catch him, he just took it in the sky.
Fuck. Well, we just saw that cyclone kick. I think that Brandon has gone night-night. One. What?
He still persists to not give up that first point because it's so much easier to catch the second loss after you've been down the first time.
Good point, Scott Towles. He's brought up a very interesting point. In a best 2 out of 3 falls match, you do not want to get the first fall or lose by the first fall, because then you have a much more obstacle to climb, an obstacle to overcome by getting 2 consecutive victories.
And here we have a pin. Not even two.
Yeah, Brandon is not going to give up, man. He's going to continue fighting until he has nothing left in him. 20 minutes left on the clock for the AWA World Title. And now, bridge German suplex. Both shoulders are down, but it's still Wolfman kicks out. Damn! It sends him on the outside floor.
What is he at? Slow motion from the first kick, like she's like,
goes, it's like, fuck.
And then another slow motion.
He got freaking slugged right in the face. That sent him outside. The trajectory of that strike was a lot. They just drag him on the floor, face down, like, fuck, man, like wouldn't his face like be burning from getting a drag on that? On that ring mat.
This is getting ruthless. This could be it. And
That's my mug.
The first fall.
Oh,
earned by Horvath.
Oh.
and he tries to cave in his face right afterwards.
Oh shit, this is gonna get heavy. This is gonna get... Oh my goodness, another European uppercut!
This could be it.
A very European uppercut. Going for the cover. One, two, no! He's still standing, Scott Towels! How is he doing this? Wait a minute. Tornado DDT from the apron. Oh, man. Just drives the knee to the chest. Brandon, come on, buddy. You have a huge obstacle around you. Oh, there it is. There's that cyclone kick we've been talking about.
Wiping the floor with him as he goes potentially for that final pinfall.
There it is. Sky Stanley's in position one. What?
Brandon persists.
Well, he didn't persist during that submission hold. He had to forfeit. Oh. There was too much punishment on the shoulders, on the arms, the back. Oh my.
This could be it.
More punishment on that back I was talking to you about.
And
there's the tap. There's the tap out. He had no choice. Brandon had no choice but to forfeit. Two consecutive wins, both by submission.
He couldn't bring him down, so he bent him in half.
And right there, that could have been an opportunity for Brandon to score a point, but the Bard came in. The Bard came in right where it was the best convenience, but he got himself ejected from the ring. Oh, look at that. Sack that, man. Horvath successfully retains the championship. That's the closing moments right there. Splitting the back in two like a piece of lumber. Oh, see, man. Well, yeah, pretty much. Congratulations, Horvath. You've retained the championship. You definitely earned beat. Now that means that Horvath is not only still AWA World Champion, but I think he's gotten 1 point higher than the Wolfman. We'll have to see the stats right after this, but before we go on to our next contest, Rick Rocker right now is standing by with the challenger for the Championship of the Universe, Kenan Jackson Jr. Rick, the floor is yours.